My interest is fundamentally how people process information and also really how the brain prevents our consciousness from having access to information. Meditation is actually a really interesting scenario in that, because you've got people who sort of by force of will and practice can control information that comes in and comes out in ways that you wouldn't normally be able to do. And so that's why we're interested in monks, because they're experts at meditating and doing that. Sitting in a monastery in the Himalayas with four senior Tibetan monks meditating in this room, it was a very surreal experience. I mean, we weren't meditating at the time because we were collecting brain data on them at the time, so we were madly making sure that our data was correct. But it was very surreal experience. My colleague and I from UVic have been playing with recording EEG at altitude and these kinds of things for a number of years, and always struggled with the technical component. The rigs that we use down here are large and expensive, and by our first couple of times up there, are prone to breaking at altitude. Altitude is a bad thing to electronics. And so in this case, it was fantastic because we brought some technology from a Canadian company, a little portable unit that you can buy at Best Buy, and then put some back-end work into it from our labs and made it able to collect brain data on Tibetan monks in a monastery in the Himalayas. This is, you know, basic understanding of how the brain processes information is really the core interest here. By doing, whether it be meditation or, you know, the next new brain training app, how much control do we have over those processes, whether it be attention or memory or learning, how much control do we have over those processes, and how able are we to train those processes, right? So now we'd be able to, you know, if the next brain training app comes out, hopefully be a way to actually say, yes, actually, there's actually differences going on, and it's not just a gimmick.